Hi, welcome to a general update from the Talyllyn Railway. We're doing it on a train today, which makes a nice change for me because I don't get on the trains very often. And we thought we'd do a bit of an update on a few bits and pieces. We had a fantastic 70s weekend last weekend and had four steam locos and two diesels out. And lots of people come and really enjoy it, and I think the volunteers got a lot out of it because putting that number of departures on really tests our blockmen and our crews, and there was lots of trains going on. So what we did, we replicated the 70s timetable, which only ran as far as Abergann-Olwyn, and then we put a shuttle on between Abergann-Olwyn and Nantgwrnawl, and there's some footage of that to show you. Also, we've welcomed a guest, Hannah Jones from Geufron Farm, which is one of our accommodation providers who do look after us very well. And we've done a few snippets of interview with her, so we'll go to that now. So we're not on the ghost train this morning, we're on the normal train. And something a little bit different today. I'm delighted to welcome a guest, Hannah. Hannah is from Geufron Farm, one of our local accommodation providers. And we're going to have a chat today as we go up the road about tourism, wood, dogs.
Yeah, all of that.
All those things. So welcome to the Saddle Inn.
Thank you. And it's lovely to be back.
We'll
I love
be
being
chatting about random stuff on the way up.
We will.
So we're approaching Riddarodden now, which is the nicest stop on the line, I think, because that's my local stop. I'm still waiting for the siding for the General Manager's Express to pull into. And Hannah has actually been quite involved in Riddarodden because she's been thieving. Well, that's not quite true. A couple of years ago, a great big tree fell down and we chopped it, we logged it.
Yeah.
And what's happened to the logs?
I have a lot of those logs,
really?
An awful lot of those logs, and they're now our sign for the farm. So when you come to the drive, you'll see me.
Some of the logs can be seen here because we made the other logs that you didn't thieve into a lovely picnic bench, which just looks super.
Yes.
So it's that sort of style of planking rather than logging. Planking.
Yeah, yeah.
So made your sign.
Made your sign, and it's the same craftsman who's made our tables as well.
Stuart
Smith,
yeah.
From Woodworks.
Very
yeah.
Clever man.
Indeed. Yeah. Really talented. And, you know, it was just lovely, I think, to be able to bring something, you know, from the local area into the cottages so that we
very
could have
local.
That real sense of place.
It's
yeah.
nice to see it used rather than burned. So
yeah.
it's been
yeah.
fab. So we'll see if we can chop any more down for you.
Lovely. Let me know when you do.
Where do you see the Talyllyn fitting in the importance in the area?
So Talyllyn Railway for me is incredibly important for not just for visitors but also for the community as well. And a huge number of our guests, they come and stay. And we get lots of sort of multi-generational families who are coming. So people who've come and enjoyed the railway, you know, in years gone by, and they're bringing back their grandkids and their kids. I just think it's such a super resource to have on our doorstep, you know, and the fact that I know you have a team, but the fact there's so many volunteers involved in it, and
400 active
people
volunteers.
Are so dedicated
yeah.
to it. I mean, I just think that is something incredibly special, and I'm really proud that that's in our area.
If you watch Hannah's videos, she'll be doing the video, and in the background is a Talyllyn Railway.
Yeah. So we see you, you know, passing every day over from the farm. And how special is that? You know, if you're coming from somewhere where, you know, maybe you've never encountered a steam engine before, and all of a sudden, you know, you're seeing one passing and the steam coming out. I just think it's beautiful. Beautiful to look at, beautiful to ride on, and great to be a part of.
So I thought I'd do a quick update on the coal situation, which we've covered quite extensively. We've been trialling a number of different alternatives to our coal. The main thing is the e-coal, which is a blend of anthracite from Aberpergam, which is in South Wales, olive waste, which is the olive stones and the husks all ground up, and that's all bound together with molasses, and that's called e-coal, so it's only half coal and half biomass. That's been working really well on our railway. We're working with the manufacturer and giving them feedback. Slightly less lumps would be good, but it works really well. It's just the cost. The cost is about three times the cost of what we were paying for Fosafan Welsh coal. So we're working on that. We've also been trialling ovoids, which is a... whereas the e-coal is a hot nugget, the ovoids is a cold nugget, so it's just a compressed fines, and that's been working okay, a little bit more ash, but it just shows that we've got lots of things going on and we are looking to see if we can find alternatives that will give us longevity of supply. So that's the coal issue and that's ongoing. Looking forward, we've got a few things coming up. We're starting our Quarryman's Trains this week, which is your guided tour train. You have a fully professional guide on the train that explains all about the history of the Talyllyn and behind the scenes. Looking a bit further forward, we've got our Anything Goes Gala in July, which is where we get everything that moves out of the box and have a bit of fun with it. So look for details on that. And then perhaps most excitingly is the Audrey Weekend, which is 23rd and 24th of July. So due to the popularity of the lecture being read out by Tim Dunn, which was fully sold out in a matter of hours for the Saturday, we're actually releasing another lecture for 10 o'clock on Sunday morning, and those tickets will be available now. So that's a summary of what's going on. Keep an eye on the website and social media for all our updates, and look forward to seeing you soon.